We will present the evidence that we believe clearly indicates that the real Sister Lucia was killed and was replaced by an impostor Sister Lucia, most likely between 1958 and 1959. If Sister Lucia was replaced by an impostor, wouldn't Sister Lucia's friend Bishop De Silva notice the impostor? Not if Sister Lucia was replaced in 1958 or 1959. Because a few months after the Vatican received the third secret in 1957, Bishop De Silva died. Although Sister Lucia met with people rarely, she met with Father Agustin Fuentes on December 26, 1957. Father Agustin Fuentes was the chief postulator for the causes of Francisco and Jacinta's beatification. This was the reason that Sister Lucia met with him. Father Fuentes, after he spoke to Sister Lucia, went back to his home country of Mexico, and on May 22, 1958, he gave a talk about what Sister Lucia said to him when he visited her. Father Fuentes said that Sister Lucia, when he met her, was, quote, very sad, very pale, and emaciated. Sister Lucia told Father Fuentes, quote, God will chastise the world, and this will be in a terrible manner. The punishment from heaven is imminent. Father, how much time is there before 1960 arrives? It will be very sad for everyone. Not one person will rejoice at all if beforehand the world does not pray and do penance. I am not able to give any other details because it is still a secret. This is the part of the message of Our Lady which will remain secret until 1960. Sister Lucia went on to say, quote, my mission is not to indicate to the world the material punishments which are certain to come if the world does not pray and do penance beforehand. No, my mission is to indicate to everyone the imminent danger we are in of losing our souls for all eternity if we remain obstinate in sin. It is necessary for each one of us to begin to reform himself spiritually. Each person must not only save his own soul, but all the souls that God has placed on our path. The devil is in the mood for engaging in a decisive battle against the Virgin. And a decisive battle is the final battle, where one side will be victorious and the other side will suffer defeat. Hence, from now on, we must choose sides. Either we are for God or we are for the devil. There is no other possibility. God is giving two last remedies to the world. These are the Holy Rosary and devotion to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. These are the last two remedies which signify that there will be no others. The Most Holy Virgin in these last times in which we live has given a new efficacy to the recitation of the Rosary to such an extent that there is no problem, no matter how difficult it is, even of the life of peoples and nations, that we cannot resolve by the prayer of the Holy Rosary. With the Holy Rosary, we will save ourselves, we will sanctify ourselves, we will console our Lord and obtain the salvation of many souls. Finally, devotion to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, our Most Holy Mother, consists in considering her as the seat of mercy, of goodness, and of pardon, and is the certain door by which we are to enter heaven. Sister Lucia told Father Fuentes that the Blessed Virgin Mary made her understand that we are living in the last days of the world. After Father Fuentes' talk, in which he related what Sister Lucia had told him, the talk was published in magazines throughout the whole world. About a year later, on July 2, 1959, Sister Lucia's Diocese of Coimbra officially came out and accused Father Fuentes of lying about what Sister Lucia said to him during their interview. They published a letter produced on a typewriter that stated, quote, Father Agustin Fuentes, postulator of the cause of beatification for the Seers of Fatima, visited Sister Lucia at the Carmel of Coimbra and spoke to her exclusively about things concerning the process in question. But after returning to Mexico, this priest allowed himself to make sensational declarations of an apocalyptic, eschatological, and prophetic character, which he declares that he heard from Sister Lucia's very lips. Given the gravity of such statements, the Chancery of Coimbra believed its duty to order a rigorous investigation on the authenticity of such news, but also with regard to things reported as having been said by Sister Lucia. The Diocese of Coimbra has decided to publish these words of Sister Lucia, given in answer to questions put by one who has the right to do so. Sister Lucia, quote, Father Fuentes spoke to me in his capacity as postulator for the causes of beatification of the servants of God, Jacinta and Francisco Marto. We spoke solely on things connected with the subject. Therefore, whatever else he refers to is neither exact nor true. I am sorry about it, for I do not understand what good can be done for souls when it is not based on God, who is the truth. I know nothing, and could therefore say nothing about such punishments which are falsely attributed to me. The Chancery of Coimbra is in a position to declare that since up to the present, Sister Lucia has said everything she believed it her duty to say about Fatima. She has said nothing new, and consequently has authorized nobody, at least since February 1955, to publish anything new that might be attributed to her on the subject of Fatima, end quote. It was after this letter was published by the Diocese of Coimbra that Father Fuentes was removed as postulator for the beatification causes of Francisco and Jacinta. On March 19, 1961, Father Louis Condor, a priest from the communist country of Hungary, was appointed to take over for Father Fuentes. So by July 2, 1959, Sister Lucia's diocese was publishing letters in her name that were false. Sister Lucia was silenced, and it was probably at this same time that the real Sister Lucia had died or was killed. It's very likely that the impostor Sister Lucia was installed around this time. This was a woman who looked somewhat like Sister Lucia. She was probably a communist agent or a paid actress. She could have also been asked or blackmailed to play the part of Sister Lucia. And once she began publicly acting as if she were Sister Lucia, she became comfortable with it, and it became her way of life. And after she did this for some time, it was too late to turn back. Our monastery, Most Holy Family Monastery, was the first organization in the world to publicly mention the concept of an impostor Sister Lucia, and to bring out the evidence supporting this idea. When we posted our article, The Whole Truth About the Consecration and Conversion of Russia and the Impostor Sister Lucy. We have to remember from Sister Lucia's own words that she did not seem to know when she would die. Otherwise, Sister Lucia would have never had Bishop De Silva promise that the third secret would be open and read to the whole world at her death or in 1960, whichever would come first. So Sister Lucia didn't know if she would live till 1960. We also know that once January 1st, 1960 arrived, Sister Lucia would begin to tell anyone and everyone she could about what the message of the third secret really was. As we have seen in its note of July 2nd, 1959, the Chancery of Coimbra declared authoritatively that, quote, Sister Lucia has nothing more to say on Fatima, end quote. It also became increasingly difficult to see her, and for years no more of her writings were published. Her testimony was becoming bothersome. Interestingly enough, Sister Lucia's confessor, Father Aparico, when he came back from Brazil in 1960, was unable to see Sister Lucia. He remarked, quote, I have not been able to speak with Sister Lucia because the Archbishop could not give the permission to meet her. The conditions of isolation in which she finds herself have been imposed by the Holy See. Consequently, no one may speak with her without a license from Rome. This permission to see Sister Lucia could only be given by two people, either by John XXIII or by the Cardinal Prefect of the Holy Office. The reason why only two people could give special permission to see Sister Lucia by 1960 was because by 1960 you were not dealing with a real Sister Lucia herself. You were dealing with the impostor Sister Lucia. On November 19, 1959, John XXIII had an audience in which he spoke about Sister Lucia. John XXIII stated about this meeting, quote, We talked at length about the seer of Fatima, today a good religious at Coimbra. The Holy Office will take care of everything and keep it on the right lines, end quote. In other words, John XXIII and his fellow conspiratorial agents will continue to hide the truth about the third secret and the newly installed impostor Sister Lucia. The impostor Sister Lucia made her first public appearance on May 13, 1967 with Paul VI. People who have seen the video of Paul VI's visit to Fatima say that he didn't even pray one Hail Mary. Here are the pictures of the real Sister Lucia from 1945 when she was 38 years old. You can judge for yourself, but the woman pictured here is not the same as the woman pictured before. First, this photograph is from 1967. Thus, this is supposedly Sister Lucia 22 years later, at age 60. But this woman looks as young or even younger than Sister Lucia when she was 38 years old. Despite showing signs of age, from age 38 to age 60, a person will essentially look the same.